Hello everybody, this is Angie, and I have a Halloween set that I made for myself. And to start off with, I found this box that I had stored in the garage, and it looks a little worn and distressed. And when I found it, I thought, well, that would be a good box to create for Halloween. And when I was going through a lot of my things and my embellishments, I found this, which fit perfectly over the top, and it says Creepy Crawloween. And what it really is over is something that looks like this, but it's more vertical. And I originally got it from Hobby Lobby. I think I paid, $2.40. It was overpriced at $12, but it worked out very, very well. And if I turn this right side again, inside it has a little album that I made for myself for a change, because I usually make these for somebody else, and I'm thinking about their style and what they want. But I decided to do something different. And this is a little album that I did based on the Halloween, what I call it, the horror classic novels. And it wasn't until I was much older that I realized a lot of the monster movies that I had already seen were based on classical novels. And I was always a reader, so I started reading some of them and it scared the bejeebies out of me. But I do have a little dangle charm, a little skeleton, a creepy little, skeleton hand. That's a charm. And one of those little kits that I got from Hobby Lobby with a skeleton that says Uncle Spooky's Skeleton Polish. And on the back, it's a witch on a broom. But, and this was all the same paper set as that embellishment. It kind of matched. So this is supposed to say Creepy Crawloween, but instead I'm cut off the C, so it says Reepy Crawloween. So that's my first page. And it's a little hard to maneuver with these big binder clips, but I don't mind because they sit up pretty well. But these are a couple of little cards from the Halloween in Wonderland Graphic 45 paper stack. And I made a little, a little file folder that I learned how to make a long time ago. And I love them because they open up like that, like an accordion file. So that'll just tie up like that. I might put a different tie on it later. But I was kind of trying to work through this real quickly. Believe me, it didn't work quickly. But anyway, in the same paper stack, they had this kind of creepy silhouettes in frames paper. And I just made a pocket. And in that pocket are some more Halloween in Wonderland tags, as well as if I want to jot down some notes to remind myself about how I made this or when I made it. And this is just an envelope that I made. And I fussy cutted some of these silhouettes, and then I popped these up here to make the envelope. And that just opens, and I could put movie tickets and things like that in there. And let's see, next page. And here is where I went into the classical novels and everything, because a lot of the witches that you see in the movies and everything are really based on some of the classic literature. And I found Macbeth. And in here it says, double, double, toil and trouble, fire burn and cauldron bubble. And I put a little Jolene's chalice here. It's kind of creepy looking. And the paper matches because it's got all the little witches bruise things. And that one even says Witch's Brew. So that's that page. Now the next page I had a little bit of a problem with, because this actually had a witch on a broom, but I had to find something to put more bats and a moon, because on this page I have a quote from the original novel Dracula by Bram Stoker. I read this book when I was like 31 years old, and it scared me. I read it in broad daylight, and it scared me a long, long time, because I've been a heavy-duty reader since I was a child, so I envisioned a lot of what was going on in the book, and it it really gave me the creeps. But anyway, one of the famous quotes from the novel is, "I am Dracula, and I bid you welcome," the Count said. His lips ran over his gums. Long, sharp, canine teeth showed out strangely. Believe me, it's much scarier than that. Because there's so many other things that go on there. Now, I made another one of my pocket envelopes and just put this on it and put another embellishment from the same stack. And that opens up that way. And then I decided to do something kind of a surprise, because when you flip this up, there's another envelope here. And I have one of those creepy little lenticular things. This one doesn't move a whole lot, but when you turn it that way, you might see a little bit. I think he's supposed to be a Dracula, but or a vampire, but I don't know. Anyway, he's supposed to be kind of creepy. Sorry about the glare. So that's a double envelope that I made to hide and make a little magical pocket that way. And then we go on to another one of my favorite Halloween stories, The Legend of Sleepy Hollow. And this quote says, "The apparition of a figure on horseback without a head, said to be the ghost of the Haitian trooper, the ghost goes forth to the scene of battle in nightly search for his head." Got the pumpkin in the way, because in the book he throws a pumpkin at Ichabod Crane. Okay, so that's why I put that pumpkin there. And next page. I really did not like the way this came out. I put those embellishments in here. And I just went ahead and said, well, okay, if I want to put a ticket or something in there, it'll slide in there. And it'll hold pretty well. And this I made on the same kind of way, the same method, as well as the other pocket envelope, as I did on my tutorial for a CD and DVD envelope. And if you want to, you could check that out on my channel. Just click down there, Mary Scrapper 13, and you can bring up a lot of my videos. All I did was I used the same technique, which is quite easy, well, for me. And, well, I think it's easy enough. And all I did is I resized it to a different size square. And everything that you do is going to be kind of like the same length. So this one opens up. I'm not going to untie it. Oh, well, let me untie it if I can. Get a little crazy with these things sometimes. Whoop. Well, there it goes. And, of course, it opens up. I didn't put another flap under here. I didn't even think about it until just now. But anyway, it doesn't matter because I did it for me. But that's the way, and it ties up, and this is embroidery string. And another magical pocket. Flip that up, and you have a moving skeleton. It's kind of creepy. And another envelope that says Boo, and just some place for movie tickets or whatever I want to put in here. And that just flops right back down. Quite easy, because what I did is I made two of these, and I put one on top of the other. I just covered this one. You can't see the flap, but that's all I did. I connected two, one on top of the other. And that's it. So if you like any of my ideas and would like to get some tutorials on that, feel free to check out my CD DVD envelope tutorial, because I show you how to do those pockets. And this may be the last video for Halloween for this year. I'm not quite sure. But I also have favor bags that you can make quite easily for Dracula or Jack Skellington. Oh, sorry, I can't talk very well today, this morning. But anyway, I really enjoyed doing this. It's for me, so it's going to stay on my shelf and on display. And if you have any questions whatsoever about any of these techniques, please feel free to jot them down there. And I thank you for your comments. I read each and every one. And I am wishing you a wonderful, creative day. Bye now.